Hello world, how's it going? So I'm up doing some late night much needed water changes on some of these aquariums, and as I was going through this algae, I noticed that it wasn't like normal hair algae, wasn't like my normal Cladophora algae. But I wanted to share this with you guys because if I didn't jump on here and do this, more than likely I wouldn't make a video about it, and I thought it was kind of neat. So let me flip you guys around and we are live here. So as I was cleaning this out, I noticed that all this Cladophora was a bunch of tiny little balls. Now it usually doesn't grow like this for me. Long time ago, I had a Marimo ball, but it wasn't in this tank. But pretty much everything that's in this tank was from the tank that I had the Marimo ball in. So the same type of algae is in here, but you can see how many is in there, which that's a lot. So I have refrained from going ahead and pulling it out. I am going to go ahead and leave them in there. I may grab some and try to grow them elsewhere. Not really quite sure how I'm going to do that. I may just separate them out into containers or something, just a few of them. And yeah, they're pretty neat looking. I enjoy it. Look how many. It's insane. They're in here with a black rose line. But there's got to be quite a few in there. Now, I've only bought a Marimo ball once, but I'll show you where what tank it actually came out of and how it usually grows. It was in this tank where I originally had the Marimo ball. But in here, it usually grows like this. It grows flat and more like a carpet. It looks really cool as a carpet. Same whenever it grows onto... well, hard to see on that stick, but often on the sticks it'll grow too, the driftwood. Kind of see it, not very well, but yeah, usually it grows straight across and flat and not so much in a ball form. There's not really much of it in here anymore. Shrimp have kind of taken care of it, plus there's so much moss and other plants within that tank. But I thought it was real neat. For some reason, in this situation, in this setup, it just decided to grow as little balls. I don't know if the shrimp have been helping with that, just kind of like cleaning the edges, even though there's shrimp in that other tank. I don't know. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments as you watch this video or even in the live here. See, this one's starting to go more flat. But what do you guys think? I mean, do you have to have a little current? Just keep it like, maybe like an egg tumbler or something? I wonder if that would grow them out. I wonder how I could get all these into like little Marimo balls without it clumping into one. Pretty neat though. Pretty neat. It's the first time I've ever seen it with all these aquariums and throughout all these years. First time I've seen it just grow like that. Alright, so I will keep this video short. And, nah, definitely not string algae. I am scrolling for questions, but hello all you guys in the chat. Great to see y'all. If they're algae, why don't algae eaters eat them? Well, really, neocaridinias aren't that great for algae eating. A lot of people get shrimp, for instance, to eat algae. Amanos will tear up some algae, but neocaridinias, caridinia species, they do not eat algae so much. So never rely on an algae diet for your shrimp. And never try to get something for your algae problems either, because then you're just putting a band-aid over a huge problem. It's like you're, yeah. You just don't want to do that. J-Rad Ironman, thank you so much for the $2 super chat. I appreciate it. Hello, J-Rad. Kevin Leong says, hi, I purchased your Neos. However, they seem like they are still very scared. Any suggestions? I've had them for 2-3 weeks. That's not uncommon for shrimp to just be scared for quite a while. What will happen often is they'll get all that new space because they're used to being in a tank where there's tons of shrimp all over the place. So when they have a whole new area and whole new space and you got those rock piles and everything going, they will go hide in there. And if you don't see them, it's a really good sign, because more than likely it means they're in there and they are breeding. So give it some time, they'll come out. Definitely the tropical granules always helps bring them out. Do purples breed true? Purples do not, there is not a true purple breed that I know of out there. It's really hard to line them up. Your shrimp must be spinning in those little ones, right? Scrolling. All right, but yeah, pretty neat for Cladophora. What shrimp are we looking at right now? This is a black rose line. Hasn't been worked that well. There is still quite a bit of Bloody Mary still in there, which some of these actually have more of a solid body. And you can see where it's kind of red and black. That's how you know it's a black rose and not just a black neo. And then you can see it throws blue dreams too. But really not bad mutation wise, because black rose can get pretty crazy with its genetics. And I've actually had a black rose line in the past where the red and the blue and the black ended up on a shrimp, and it actually created a tricolor neo. So it ended up having black, red, and blue within the color of the shrimp. It was really awesome. I got pictures somewhere on it, and I believe there even may be a YouTube video, old YouTube video, that I showed those. It was really unfortunate. I brought my black rose that I had won at the first international contest back and just put them in their tank, and, well, I really should have quarantined them first. Ooh, there's one that kind of, where'd he go? He's kind of starting to look like one of those. Still missing the blue, though. It'd be cool if they did it again. Some of my blacks have a cream back stripe. Yeah, some of those will. So those are, I think those are more on the lines of regular black neos. Sometimes you can get them with yellow stripes as well, where that cream white stripe can go yellow. It's really neat. It's crazy some of the mutations you could really get deep down into some shrimp. Like I was saying in my last Friday Night Live stream, I had blues with orange stripes on them a long time ago, but I don't even know how that was created or how that even got by. Got any giant danios? No, I don't, but I really wish I did. I problem with having a business is I can't keep as many like show tanks as I would want to. But I absolutely love community only giant danios, or maybe something else on the bottom. I got these catfish that would do great with giant danios, but just to watch them, they're always so busy. It's really cool. Zeph loves cat says, LRB, I got some orange shrimp from you. One ended up buried, but I really think for some reason they've been cannibalizing each other, even though I feed daily. Any tips? So, if they're cannibalizing, more than likely, I don't know if they're lacking a protein. Big reason why I love this stuff, Tetracolor Tropical Granules, which is not sponsored, is it is high in protein. And I don't know, if you're feeding them once a day, should be enough. Because you see how many's in here. This is just up front. And I haven't even fed them yet. But even in the back, it's still covered all the way back there, full of them. Because you have all that moss, you have rock piles underneath that moss. It just gives it tons and tons of coverage for these guys. J-Rad Iron Man, thank you so much for the $5 super chat. Says, what are the black strains of neos and the colors they throw? So it all depends on where it derived from. Depends on what you're really going to get from them. But then again, there's like what I was talking about earlier. This is more of a black rose line. You can usually tell the difference. So the regular black neocaridinia lines will sometimes have the stripes in them. The body will be different. The black rose, they have this red sheen to them. Look at that big old mama. And that's really how you can tell the difference. There you can kind of, there's a really starting to come out of one of them. But all it is they were derived from, I believe, the more red form. And I think the other blacks are derived more from the blue form, if I remember right. Alright, I'm going to keep this short. This is a 10-gallon tank. But I thought that was really neat. So I'll probably end up getting this container here, throwing some in there. And I could probably put it on a windowsill, see how it grows out. I don't know if it would flatten. Maybe a light power head, but I don't know if I really have a tank to set all that up. But to maybe keep these rotating and tumbling and actually make full adult Marimo balls might be a cool little challenge. I don't know. What do you guys think? Should I tackle that? Should I go through all that? Let me know in the comments down below. And I got to hop off here because I still got to change this whole rack. And it's like 1:30 a.m. right now. And these tanks need to go off soon because I got to go to bed. But this has to get done. It's been needing done for a long time. I mean, this tank was just full of algae. I'm going to end up putting Java fern in there. I've already got my replacement plants. Tons of them. Wendelov and I think Philippine fern in there. Anyways, I need to get back to it. I appreciate you all. Thank you. Thank you so much. And until next time, everybody, peace. Have a great one. Wing.